from here, I'm going to turn to location 5 miles west of my office in the Chimney Hollow Valley, and we're going to get a live report through Zach Allen and Joe Donnelly on the Chimney Hollow construction. It's our honor and privilege to be for that project to be underway on behalf of the Windy Gap Firming Project participants. With that, Jenna, if you'd hand over the screen to those gentlemen.
Welcome to Chimney Hollow Valley. Appreciate you taking the time this morning and hearing us talk about all the things going on in Northern Water. I know a lot of you have been attending our Fall Water Users and Fall Symposiums for decades now and hear us talk about the Windy Gap Firming Project and Chimney Hollow Reservoir. And I guess it's exciting to actually show you that all of this hard work, the fortitude, the perseverance has paid off, and we're here building this project right now today. I'll probably just give you a little bit of background. I know some of you might also just be new to the project. So when we talk about Chimney Hollow Reservoir and Windy Gap Firming Project, those are synonymous terms. 20 years ago, with the as President Applegate mentioned this morning, the six cities filed on the water rights for the Windy Gap project, and then we built the Windy Gap project. But because that's a junior water right with no dedicated storage, we've always had, we sometimes have zero firm yield out of year. Some years we can't pump, some years we can. So even though we do deliver quite a bit of water out of that Windy Gap project, we needed a reservoir or storage to firm those water rights and consistently deliver in our ultimate goal of 30,000 acre feet per year. We have 12 participants who have stuck with this project for the last 20 years, and they've been a big part of this as well. And it's ultimately the benefits of this water storage will go to those participants. So with that, just to catch you up, where things are at, we did receive all of the permits for this project in 2017. We also started working on the design. We finished the design in February of 2020. We hired Barnard Construction, our contractor, Stantec, our engineer, and Black & Veatch, our construction manager, and we were able to break ground out here at Chimney Hollow in August of this year. So we're about 2.5 months into construction. So just to give you a little bit of an idea of what's going on, Chimney Hollow is going to ultimately be the second tallest dam in the state of Colorado, and it's the largest dam that's been built in all of the United States in 25 years. I'm standing currently on what's going to be the upstream toe of the Chimney Hollow Reservoir. So if you look over my shoulder here, up at the top, you can see an excavator digging 350 feet off the valley floor, and they're working on the foundation preparation for the main dam in Chimney Hollow. The dam is then going to extend 3/4 of a mile across this valley and tie in at the far slope over there. Some other things that we have going on right now are, you can see that rockfall fence straight across the valley. That's ultimately going to be the downstream tunnel portal for Chimney Hollow, where we get water in and out of Chimney Hollow. So they got the rockfall fence going in there, and they're beginning to build a soil nail wall to transition to rock for that tunnel. So it'll be an 80-foot cut in the area over there. The other things you see going on around us is really it's mainly the excavation for this main dam. Ultimately, we have about 2 million cubic yards of material that we have to pull out of this foundation so that we can build the dam on rock. So you'll see a number of trucks working around here. I think we have 5 excavators, very large excavators, digging in this main dam footprint, supported by about 15 haul trucks at the moment. You can see this excavator working. Just to give you an idea of the size of this equipment, every bucket full of dirt in that excavator is about 15 tons of material. So big equipment running around out here. Ultimately, this Chimney Hollow Reservoir, the dam, is going to be an asphalt core dam. So it's also a pretty unique structure. It'll be the second asphalt core dam built in the United States, although there are about 200 of these types of dams that have performed across the world over the last 80 years. all of the material to build our dam is going to come from an on-site quarry that's located from below the future high water line of the reservoir. And so that our quarry operations are permitted at 63,000 tons per day. So ultimately, that's going to be the largest hard rock mining operation in the state. So significant project going on out here. Ultimately, this is a four-year construction project. It's valued at about $500 million. So we're about 5% of the way through construction. So we're just on the very beginning here. Just a couple other things have happened since we started work 2.5 months ago. The contractors mobilized about 145 people out here, as well as about 65 pieces of mobile equipment. We're working essentially 12-hour shifts, Monday through Friday, 10-hour shifts on Saturdays. Generated about 55,000 work hours with no injuries. So that's a great statistic for us. And we've currently moved about 700,000 cubic yards of material out of this footprint. So with that, just maybe I'll end on this project. The reason this was permitted, one of the things that helped us get these permits through was a really robust mitigation plan, where we have a lot of commitments on the west slope to protect the Colorado River, including the Colorado River connectivity channel that will ultimately let the Colorado River flow free around our Windy Gap project. And then here on the east slope, we also have purchased this property jointly with Larimer County, so that this will ultimately become a 3,500 acre public open space for the people of Northern Colorado. So with that, I'll just end. I will say, if you are interested in this project, please visit our website at www.chimneyhollow.org for additional information. So I'll turn it back over to Jeff to see if there's any questions or comments.
Thanks, Joe. I'll fill in for Jeff. We've been on this effort construction since August 16th. What's been the biggest surprise on site that he's experienced in that 2.5 months?
That's a good question. We've had a couple things to change at any kind of big, heavy civil project like this. You have unknown ground conditions. So I would say the biggest surprise we've had is the bedrock's a bit higher in our tunnel portal area. So working through that. And then in the very center of the valley of Chimney Hollow, the bedrock's been maybe 20 feet lower than what we had originally thought. So everyone's working together, our engineer, construction manager, contractor, to plan out how we're gonna work through some of those change conditions. I wouldn't say that was necessarily a big surprise to us. We always knew we were gonna have to work through these kind of changes in the ground conditions as we started construction. So
thank you, Joe. And Zach, and Joe, looking to the south and or Zach, we've got a quarry that's underway, as well as the saddle dam clear on the south end under construction.
One thing I guess I will point out is right now you can see some concrete work up there by the Flatiron penstocks. We are doing our first concrete pour on the site this morning. And so that's actually the future bridge that's gonna be for the public rec area that crosses over those Flatiron penstocks to the public open space parking lot. So lots going on site.
Great, thank you, Joe. Thank you, Zach, for the live update on Chimney Hollow construction. We'll hope to bring you the same experience, but with the rising of a dam over the next 4 years.